CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 4.3, Explain the Purpose and Use of Programming Concepts. Identifiers. In this video, we will learn about two specific types of program identifiers, a variable and a constant. But first off, let's talk about identifiers as a whole. You can think of an identifier as a symbolic name that points to a specific location in the computer's memory. Just like your name helps people identify you, identifiers help the computer keep track of different pieces of information, referred to as values. Looking at the graphic behind me, you can imagine the computer's memory or RAM as a bunch of boxes. Each box holds some data. It could be a number, a word, or anything else. Identifiers are like labels on these boxes. They tell the computer which box to look in when it needs that particular piece of information. Great, now we can break this topic down a bit more and focus on a specific type of identifier called a variable. In keeping with our box analogy, a variable is like an open box that can hold different things at different times. For example, you might have a variable called num2 that holds an integer value. You can put different values into this box, and the computer will remember them. Maybe you start with the value 20, but then change it to 47. The variable num2 can be reassigned to the new value just like that. And though the value has changed, the identifier's symbolic name and the location where it is stored in memory will not. Our next type of identifier is called a constant. This will behave very similar to a variable at first. With a constant, our box will start open, but once we assign a value to a constant, the box will be closed for the remainder of the program's runtime. In short, a constant holds a single value that doesn't change. Imagine you have a box labeled pi. You then assign the value 3.14 to the constant pi. From that moment forward, our box will be sealed and you will be unable to change this value. Now that we know what a variable and a constant are, there is one last thing I want to cover before we jump into our first coding example. Once again, look at this flowchart. Where does our program start? I hope you shouted out, at the top. And if you did, you are right. Coding works the same way. Reading code line by line, from top to bottom, is fundamental to programming. When looking at a program, you will need to get comfortable sequentially following the execution path of the program from the first line at the top to the last line at the bottom. Doing so enables you to track variable changes, understand the flow of logic, and observe control structures. Just as you read a book or follow a set of instructions step by step, reading code linearly allows you to progressively build a comprehensive understanding of how the program operates. Now we can work with some very simple code. 5 lines of code to be exact. I have even numbered the lines of code to help keep things organized. So where should I start? At the top, with line 1 of course. Here we see x equals 5. This is called an assignment statement, as it assigns a variable with a value, in this case the integer 5. You can read this quite literally as x is assigned with the value 5. For this assignment statement, the identifier is x. This is the symbolic name that will be used by the computer to reference the value's stored location in memory. The equal sign here is referred to as an assignment operator as it performs the function of assigning a value, and 5 is the value being stored. The order is also very important. The identifier will always be on the left and the value on the right of the assignment operator. If you look at the top right of the screen, I have intentionally positioned a box that will help us keep track of our variable values as we progress through the lines of code. Okay, on to line 2. Here the value of x is replaced with the integer 6. Because it is a variable, we can reach in and remove the 5 and replace it with the 6. Now, on line 3, we see something a bit different. Here the current value of x is 6, but we are going to replace it with its current value plus 2, causing our new value to be 8. On line 4, we will be declaring a new variable y. This y variable will be assigned the current value of x, which happens to be 8. And for our last line of code, we will declare yet another variable z and assign it the value of x plus y. Since the value of x is currently 8 and the value of y is currently 8, z will become 16. This should give you some insight into how variables work. As for constants, the process is the same with the exception that you cannot change the value after the initial assignment. So where do you use these variables and constants? Well, just about any time a program needs to store a value in a place that can be accessed quickly and where you need the value to remain in memory only while the program is running. And there you have it, the basics of variables and constants with regards to computer programming. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.